Hey guys, it's Marshall from Going Gear, and today we're going to take a look at the Nightcore Tiny Monster TM26 Quad Ray. So this is going to be the super in-depth, long review. If you want to see a really quick one, we also have one of those, so check out the description, and also put an annotation on this video so you can see that. Anyway, Nightcore TM26. Let's open up the box, show you what you get on the inside. There's also a user manual, which I highly recommend reading. I left it in the other room, but there is one that comes with it. You get the warranty card, the other stuff that you have in here, so you have some spare O-rings, a spare little charging port cover, a lanyard. You have the charger, because this is a rechargeable light. It does not come with batteries, but it is rechargeable. And then, of course, the light and the holster. So you can see how the light fits in the holster. You got your standard attachment point, so you have the hook and loop on the back, hook and loop flap on the front. Attachment point here, you can attach it to your belt or pack or however else you want to put it on your gear. So let's slide all that stuff out of the way. Take the light out. Take a little bit closer look at this guy. So pretty cool light. One of the first things that you'll notice on here is it actually has a little LED screen, which is really, really cool. I thought it was kind of gimmicky at first, but after using the light, it's super useful. A lot of great features in there, but we'll talk about that more here in a little bit. There's the switch that controls the functions. That's the switch that controls the functions of the LED. So this is going to control the functions of the actual light. And then here on the other side, here's your charging port. So you have that little cover that you can flip up. Charger plugs in right there. You have a tripod attachment point, so you can attach this to a tripod. Had a lot of photographers and guys like that that really like that feature. You can have it positioned however you want. And I actually had somebody show me a mount that you could attach somewhere on your vehicle. It's like a little clamp mount for a tripod that will make this a very cool vehicle light, so you can spot stuff where your headlights are not pointing. Anyway, so that's the exterior of the light. We'll kind of turn it around so you can see the different points. There's the back, there's the business end, there's your four LEDs, so four Cree XML LEDs, each with their own separate reflector, each with their own lens and bezel and all that kind of stuff. So, relatively large LEDs, relatively small reflectors. This isn't going to be a mega ultra thrower, but you're still going to get solid distance out of this. It's going to be a little over 400 meters. I think they rated at, I need to look at the actual box, 415 meters. So good distance out of this thing, better than you saw with the TM11 and the TM15, but it's not going to be like your kilometer thrower like you see from some of the Olights or anything like that. But honestly, I have to actively search for a place that's even 400 meters for me to shine a light. I know that's not a case for a lot of people. This would be useful for definitely most people out there. So that's the exterior. Turn around a little bit more. Let's open this thing up, show you the inside. So here's the inside of the head and the battery compartment. We're gonna go ahead and stick four 18650s in the light. We're gonna use some of the EagleTac 3100 milliamp hour ones with the Panasonic cells. I really like these batteries, highly recommend them. These and the 3400s they also make. Great, great batteries. But we got four of those in there. That's obviously how you're going to be able to recharge it. This light is also compatible with eight CR123 batteries, but those are not rechargeable. So if you plug it in while those are in there, you might have some issues. I do not recommend that. So you can see the little LED screen turning on. Button kicks in. You have a little LED ring around it, showing you that the light does have batteries in it. And you can turn that off, you can lock out the light. Honestly, it's a lot easier just to disconnect the battery tube a little bit and all of that will disconnect and you won't have anything draining from the batteries when it's not on. The battery drainage is gonna be super, super low. It's not gonna be a whole lot more than the natural discharge of the batteries, but if you're only using the light occasionally, you don't want it draining, make sure you lock it out or just disconnect the battery tube. So we'll turn it back on and let's show you the interface of this guy. So again, the light is controlled by this button. The LED screen is controlled by this button. So it's got a two-stage switch. So if you've seen the TM11 or the TM15, same switch, same interface that you saw on those. And if you think of like a camera shutter switch where you press halfway to do the focus and then press all the way to release the shutter, same kind of concept. So this one, press halfway and it's gonna go into your general lighting mode where you have four different outputs. You can lightly press, do that half press, and it'll cycle between your four different outputs. And then to do the full output, when you have it off, press it all the way. Don't do the half press, but click it all the way, and it'll turn it to the max output of the 3500 lumens. These batteries are getting pretty low. Hopefully they'll last through the review. I'll charge them before we go outside. So again, half press, and then you can do the half press just to cycle between the different outputs. Full press will turn it off, and then again, full press will get you to your max output. You can also do a half press when you're in that, to cycle down to the high, right below the turbo output of the 1700 lumens. So let me show you that LED screen a little bit better. We'll talk about the strobe and everything here in just a second. But little LED screen is going to be dependent on the mode that you're in. So right now I have it in the lowest one, so I don't completely drain the batteries. It'll show you the level, the lumens that you have right now, the voltage of the batteries. You can see these are getting pretty low. Little battery meter. This will show you the runtime based on the current mode that you're in. So these are pretty low, and you still have greater than 222 hours because it's at that really low 3-lumen mode. And if these are fully charged, it's something like 1,000 hours that you can get out of your 4 18650s. You also have the temperature, so you can see when the light is starting to overheat and when it's going to start dropping the output just to protect the light. So you have that little indicator right there, and then it'll go back to your level indicator. And let me bump it up to the next one just so you can see how they're dependent. So there you go, you see the lower runtime. And if we kick it up to the max output, you'll start seeing this number climbing. But I don't want to do it because I have very little battery life left. So just trust me that it does it. There's also some indicators of the charging when you actually charge this thing. So it'll show you that it's charging and tell you when it's done and give you a little battery meter and all that kind of stuff. So for the flashing modes, zoom back out, show you how you access those. So to access the flashing modes, what you do is when you have it on, double click it. So do two full clicks. You have strobe, and then you can do half presses to cycle between your other flashing modes. You have SOS. You have the beacon flashing mode when it's going to do just an occasional flash, and then you can go back to strobe. So those are your flashing modes. Like I said, there's also a lockout mode if you want to do that. I find it easier just to turn the battery tube. You also have momentary, so if you press the switch and hold it, you'll get a momentary, and you can do that with the half press or the full press. So if you hold it for longer than a half second or so, that's when you're going to start getting the momentary. Let's see if I just press it really quickly. That's the constant on. Half press, hold it for a little bit and then release it. That's when you get your momentary. So again, on the interface, half press to turn it on. Keep on half pressing to cycle between your different modes. Full click to turn it off. Full click to go to max output. You can half press to go down to the next lowest output. To get into the flashing modes, double click and then half press will cycle between your different flashing modes. And you have all this information on your screen when you're in the general illumination modes. All kinds of different information on there. So really cool light. They knocked it out of the park with this one. I was again thinking the little LED screen was kind of gimmicky, but after starting to use it, really cool features, definitely useful information on there. And I think it actually looks really nice. So it integrates into the body really well, gives it a cool kind of industrial look. They did a really good job on this one. Okay, we have the TM26 with the previous Tiny Monster, the TM15. This is still in production, still a great light, just some different features and everything on it. Deeper reflectors on this, so it's going to be a little bit longer than the TM26, but you can see difference in the size and shape. Both relatively compact, fit in your hand very comfortably. One thing I forgot to mention before is that when you're in the general lighting or the lower lighting modes, you can actually get to the max 3500 lumen output. If you have it in there, just do a half press and hold, and it'll go right into the 3500 lumens. And then you can do the half presses to keep on cycling between your other different outputs. So that's the interface. Batteries on this, 4 18650s or 8CR123s. You can use fewer batteries if you want to. You're obviously not going to get the runtime or the output that you're going to get with all the batteries in there. But if you're in an emergency situation, you only have access to a few batteries, you can put them in there. You'll be good to go. Don't ever mix battery types or even battery brands. Make sure you have all the same kind of batteries in here just to avoid any issues. And again, don't try to charge CR123s. that's gonna cause you some problems. Only try to charge 18650s in the TM26. So we're gonna go and take this outside. We'll show you how this does outside so you can get an idea of how it works in a real world situation.
All right, we're outside with the TM26. Got the big 40 mag light I always use as a control. So here that is. Bush 15 feet, tree out there at 100 feet. Let's try out the TM26. Try out the lower outputs first. And just to show you, it is on. Obviously, it's going to be for more up close kind of stuff. But let's bump it up, show you the higher outputs. I really like the beam on this. The multi LEDs and everything give you a combination of a nice wide hotspot that lights up a whole lot at once, good transition into this bill. And a really bright spill, so it just lights up everything that's going on in front of you. Really good transition and everything. very, very usable beam. Just to show you the max output, there's that max 3500 lumens. Shine that around. Obviously a whole ton of light coming off of this thing. I'll cycle between all the different outputs and everything. Brought the TM15 out here as well, to show you the difference between the two. TM26 on the left, TM15 on the right. Honestly, you're not going to notice a whole heck of a lot of difference at this kind of distance. But we have a little bit more distance to work with here in just a second. We'll show you what that looks like. Let's go ahead and try these out at a longer distance so you can see it a little bit better. All right, we got the tiny monsters out here. Got the 40 maglite, some more distance to work with. Tops of those trees at about 100 yards. Doesn't really make it out there, the 40 maglite. But again, less expensive light, older technology. It's just the one I always use and the ones everybody's familiar with. So TM15 on the left, TM26 on the right. This shows you a little bit better the difference in the beams. So if you're wondering between the two, hopefully that'll give you a better idea. And then eventually we'll get both of these out to the farm so you can see even better how they do at the different distances and everything. All right, let's just use the TM26. Whole lot of light coming out of this thing. Nice, really wide beam. I mean, pretty much all those trees out there are lit up. And if you've seen my other reviews, a lot of times the lights, they're putting out these kind of lumens. Not that many put out these kind of lumens, but the larger lights, the more expensive stuff, they're not lighting up as wide of an area. So that's what you get with the multiple LEDs. You get the distance and a nice wide beam and a nice wide spill. You can see the top of my house down there at about 30 yards lit up really well. Great combination of just everything. A lot of cool features. Definitely a really nice light. Let's drop it down to the lower outputs just so you can see what those look like. A little bit more of a distance. Definitely a very cool light. I like it a lot. This one's actually becoming my personal one when the review is done. So I'm going to throw this in my truck and I need a nice big bright light. All right, so that is the Nightcore TM26 Quadway, part of their Tiny Monster series. If you like it, you can buy it from us at goinggear.com. Any questions or comments, you can reach us in the comments or at goinggear.com. If you like the video, be sure to subscribe. We put out a ton of flashlight and other kind of gear videos. Have some other channels too if you're into other kind of stuff. This is mostly going to be about flashlights in this channel. And we're going to start doing shorter reviews. So if you don't want to watch these real long in-depth ones, if you don't have much time or you just don't have the attention span, like me, I'm not saying there's anything wrong with that. I have trouble. I get antsy sitting through long videos. So if you want to watch shorter ones with just real quick high-level bullet points, we're going to do those as well. So you can watch either or both, whatever you want to do. So again, you can buy it at goinggear.com. Questions or comments, reach us in the comments or at goinggear.com. Thanks for watching. What do you think of that one, Quinn? Do you like that one? Yeah, that's a pretty good one. Tastes good? Works well? Fun to play with? Please don't give your children these. I took the batteries out. Uh-oh.